We're joined now by David Isenberg from the British American Security Information Council, a security think tank here in Washington. Mr. Isenberg, one thing that the U.S. Army usually excels at is labeling, tagging, counting, and keeping track of its equipment. What went wrong in Iraq?
The Army didn't follow its own standard operating procedures. The GAO report you cited specifically mentions that one of the main problems was that the Army and the U.S. military overall in Iraq had been freed up from normal accounting procedures. They didn't have to follow their normal methods of accountability for tracking the weapons and dispersing the weapons. They didn't even keep a property book until late 2005.
So, in effect, the Pentagon excused itself or its army in Iraq from all of its normal accounting procedures.
Precisely.
And once they discovered they had a problem, Stuart Bowen, the IG, the Inspector General of Reconstruction, has said they were then faced with the, you know, what's become classic Iraq problem, not enough people on the ground, and the people on the ground, not enough training to do the job.
Yeah, this has been a problem which has been in the works for some time. Mr. Bowen issued a report late last year in which he noted that of the approximately 500,000 weapons, you know, ranging from rifles to pistols to RPGs, etc., only about 12,000 or so actually had their serial numbers registered. You know, that's a huge amount. And that doesn't even, and it should be noted, that doesn't also take into account another huge influx of weapons that the U.S. had transferred all the way from the Balkans, from Bosnia specifically, starting back in 2004. That was about another 200,000.
Now, Secretary Rumsfeld has said again and again and again, the Secretary of Defense can't be expected to keep track of such minute details. But the fact that these details went so spectacularly awry, isn't this again another reflection of, in a sense, the overconfidence, the almost contempt with which the Pentagon approached the Iraqi as this was the Iraqi theater as this was going to be easy. We could do this as an improvisation.
Well, to paraphrase something Secretary Rumsfeld said in the past, I guess, you know, they went to war with the accounting system that they had, not the one that they wanted. But even that is being too kind to him, because, in fact, the military does, in fact, have agencies specifically dedicated to doing this. It has the Defense Contract Audit Agency. It has a Defense Contract Management Agency. It has its own in-house corps of auditors, in other words, to track things exactly like this. And the fact that they didn't send them is in fact a reflection of what you're saying. It's also a reflection of the fact they simply didn't send the people over in the first place that was required and that people knew were required.
David Isenberg from BASIC, thank you very much for joining us.
My pleasure.